Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how you can model a basic table a bit like this inside a Blender. If you want to use this table as a reference for modeling this table, you can download the file in the description below to follow along. For now, I'll just press G and X with my object selected, and I'm just going to move it along. Then I'm going to press Shift A, and under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube. I'm then going to use the S key, which allows me to scale an object. So think of it as S for scale. Then I'll just size it down by moving my mouse. And you can see I can adjust the size of my object very easily this way. However, I want to squish it down to make this top part of the table here. To do that, I can scale it on just one axis. Notice here, this gizmo here showcases a Z, a Y, and an X axis. So you can see the Z axis is this blue up and down axis. So to squish it that way, all I need to do is press S and then choose Z. So think of it as scaling it or changing the size of it with S, and then choosing Z to squish it on that Z axis. I'll just move my mouse until I'm kind of happy with the size. I can also view my object straight on by left-clicking one of these circles here. So for example, if I press this blue Z circle, it's going to view the top view. To view this one of the sides, I can choose one of these green circles. And the good thing about this is it's laptop friendly as well. I can also move my object by pressing G, so think of it as G for grab, and I'm going to choose Z to move it up on that Z axis. Then I can press S and Z again, just to scale it so it's roughly the same size. I'm not going to go for a perfect replica here, but if you want to, then you can just overlap these objects to get the perfect proportions. You'll notice though, the top part of our table is still pretty square, and I went for a more rectangle shape. So to fix that, I'm going to then press the S key again for scale, and this time I'll choose Y, which will allow me to scale it across the Y axis, which is that green line. I'll move it to about there. Again, I can left click this red circle this time to see how it's looking on this view. So I'll press S and then Y again, and you can see I've actually lined it up pretty accurately there. For the next part, we're going to use a handy add-on so we can quickly add a mirror modifier, which is going to allow us to edit our object a little quicker. The mirror modifier isn't an add-on, but what this add-on will do is allow us to apply it very quickly and save us a bit of time. So to add this add-on, all I'm going to do is go to Edit and then go to Preferences. If you're in Blender 4.1 or earlier, you can go to this menu called Add-ons. And here you would just be able to search for Mirror and it would show up in here. However, in Blender 4.2, we now use the Extensions option, which means we have to install it from the internet first. So I'll go to Get Extensions, and in Get Extensions, I'm going to search for Mirror. Then where it says Auto Mirror, we can just choose Install. Once it finishes, you'll see it is gone like this, and you can find out more information on this website here. Then I'll go to Add-ons, and I can then search for Mirror, and you can see we have it here. Now we've added that add-on, all I need to do is press N, and that's going to open up this side panel. I can then scroll all the way down to my Edit option in the side panel, and here you'll see an option called Auto Mirror. I can open up this menu, and here we've got some settings. But before we do that, we first need to apply the scale, as we've done some scaling inside of object mode. If you don't know anything about applying the scale, make sure to check out my video where I explain why it is so important. To apply the scale, all I need to do is press Ctrl and then A, and this will open the Apply menu. Then I can just choose Scale. And now, all I can do is, you can see in Auto Mirror, we have a few options. There's X, Y, and Z. The ones we're only needing today is X and Y. So first, I'll choose X, and then I'm going to choose Auto Mirror. Now, when I go into Edit Mode, which you go into by pressing Tab on the keyboard, you'll notice that only half of our table can actually be selected. And you'll notice if I select one of these faces, so I'll press 3 on the keyboard, go into Face Select Mode, and left-click this face to select it, and then press G, you'll notice how it's going to move both sides at the same time. I'm going to press Tab to go back into Object Mode, and I'm going to take this a step further by mirroring the Y axis too, since we're going to be pulling down these legs and we have 4 of them, so we might as well do all sides at once. So I'll left-click the Y this time, and then press Auto Mirror. Then when I press Tab to go into Edit Mode, you can see I've now got just one face, and when I move it, it's going to move all those faces at the same time. If I come down to this blue spanner option here, which is called Modifier Properties, you can see two modifiers have been added, and these are the mirror modifiers which I told you about. For now, we can just leave them as they are. To start off, I'm going to add some loop cuts. A loop cut is pretty much just a bunch of edges which go through the center of a certain set of faces. So I'll press Ctrl R, which is the hotkey for loop cut, and you can see here I can choose where I want to place it. I'm going to place one here to start with, so I'll just left click here, and then I'm going to press Ctrl R again, and I'm going to left click here too. Then if you want to move a loop cut, you can first of all select it by pressing Alt left click on the loop cut, making sure you're in Edge Select mode still, which is 2 in the keyboard, and then we can press G twice, so G and then G, and that's going to allow you to slide it along. I'm going to move it to roughly where the center of of the leg will be. So I'm going to left click this blue circle again so I can see it from the bottom view. I'll then press Alt left click on the other loop we created and press G twice to move this one down. Now I'll press Shift Alt left click and select this loop. Shift Alt left click allows you to select multiple loops at once. And then we're going to be using a command called bevel. So to do that, I'm going to press Control and then B, and that's going to allow me to create this effect here. And here, this square here is going to become our leg. But you'll notice a leg is not the only thing I created. I also created a little connecting piece in between. So I'll show you how I created that as well. I'll left click this blue circle again to go into the bottom view. And this time I'm going to press Control R again and create a new loop cut in the middle. Then press Control R once more and create another loop cut through this center as well. Just left click to place it and right click to keep it in the middle. Then I'll press Shift Alt left click to select this loop as well. And I'm going to press Control B and I'm going to scale it up to roughly where I had it. And that's going to be so we can select this middle connecting part here as well. Great, now we have everything. We just need to select everything and then extrude it. Extruding is the process of just pretty much bringing out geometry. So to do that, I'm going to go into face select. So I'll press 3 on the keyboard and then I'm going to left click this face here, shift left click this face here. Then I'm going to shift left click this face here. And we can do Control Shift left click and then choose the opposite corner to select this entire set of faces. Now I've got all of those selected, I'm going to go ahead and press this red circle here to go into the side view, and I'll press E, which is going to allow me to extrude, and I can just pull this down to roughly about here. Now when I rotate around, you can see we've got the first part of our table, and now all we have to do is the leg. So as you might have guessed, we just need to select these faces here. We can do that Control Shift left click again, and even though we don't have any other faces selected, we still need to do Control Shift left click. So I'll press Control Shift and then left click, and that's going to select that entire face. Then I'll go into my side view again by pressing this green circle, and then press E and then Z just to pull this down. Z will allow me to lock it to this Z axis. And there, now we have modeled our table successfully. You can see I made these legs a little bit chunkier than the other one. You can of course though make these thinner if you like, and to do that all we need to do is press Alt left click on this set of faces here. Again, it's faces, so make sure you press 3 on the keyboard in edit mode to go into face select mode. Then I can press Shift Alt left click on this set of faces here. We'll need to get the inside ones as well, so I'll press Shift Alt left click on this set of faces here. Then I can just Shift left click the rest of the faces around here, and I'll press Shift left click and then Shift Control left click to select this bottom set of faces here. And this time we can press S to scale, and we'll choose Shift Z. What this will do is it will use every axis apart from the Z axis. So that means only the X and Y axis will be scaled on, and I can just scale things down that way. And you can see we've got much thinner legs now. If you don't like how all of these edges have gone skewed though, there's an easy way you can fix that too. I'll press 2 on the keyboard and press left click on this edge here, and I'll select the ones on the other side with just shift left click and then control left click. Control left click just allows you to select in a row like that using the pick shortest path. Then I'm wanting to line it up with this edge here, so I'll shift left click this one and then shift left click it again, so you can see how the edge has gone white, which means it's the active selection. Then if we wanted to flatten this out, we could do it by pressing S, Y and then 0, but you'll notice it's just going to average it out in the middle, which isn't what we want. But we want to flatten it out using this edge here as a reference point. So to do that, I can come up to my transform pivot point and then choose active element. Now when I press S, Y and then 0, you can see it flattens out that way, and now we have a nice straight line again. I can of course do this for the other ones as well, so I could shift left click those ones there, and then I can press control left click to select the rest of these edges. Then I'll shift select one of my edges here to use it as a reference, and I can press S, X, and then 0. You'll notice it'll create a bit of overlap here, but we can fix that by simply just repeating the process. I'll left click that edge there, and I'm going to control left click it up here. Then I'll shift left click this edge here, and I'm going to then press S, X, and then 0. And that's going to flatten it out. And you can repeat that process for as many edges as you want to straighten out. So that's a great way to give you a little bit of cleaner topology as you're working. I want you to go ahead and try and finish this process on your own, and I'll get back to you when we're done. And there, now we've straightened out all of our edges successfully. This will help make sure we have nice clean bevels later as well. And yeah, that just about covers it. In the next video, I'm going to be going over some finishing touches. If you want to learn more about modeling, make sure to check out my modeling playlist where I go over some of the fundamentals you need to know for modeling in Blender. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.